Drop nets are one of a variety of methods we use to perform our captures. Though it may look chaotic, this is actually a very safe, effective, and efficient way to perform our mule deer captures.
Hi, my name is Amelia Breitenbach, and I am the Senior Wildlife Technician for the Magic Valley region. I help coordinate mule deer capture efforts, and the data we collect from these captures helps inform us on mule deer populations, survival rates, and habitat use.
We use nets to capture mule deer so that we can put our hands on them and actually collect more information on mule deer herds. So we want to collect how old they are. We want to put GPS trackers on them so we can see their migratory routes. And we also take other measurements so that we can assess the health of our mule deer population. Once we get hands on the deer, we restrain them by putting hobbles on them so that they cannot hurt themselves or our employees. We also put a blindfold on them to help keep them calm. Deer are a lot more calm when you remove their visual stimulus and they can't see all the people moving around them. As you can see from this deer, she's just laying there as our people prepare her to be processed and for us to gather our data. Here is a mule deer fawn being outfitted with a GPS collar. As you can see, we put foam on the collar so that as the fawn grows, the foam can fall off and the collar will still be a comfortable fit. One last measurement we take before release is body weight. This helps us determine how healthy the fawn is at this time of year. Once the animal is processed, we pick it up, making sure to support its spine and head, and move it away from all human obstructions and other people so that we can safely release it on the landscape. This particular drop net effort was performed on private land, and the private landowners actually were able to come out and help us release the deer that we captured. Once released, we can now track the mule deer using their GPS collars and collect data on their movement and survival. We can use this information to help inform land use and population management decisions affecting our Idaho mule deer.